We're going to show you some fantastic ATVs with Larry. Now, if you do hear some shooting in the background, no, we are not in teal. They're not the sound of gunfire. They are
propane cannons. They are chase away the birds in the vineyards.
Okay, so we have here Ryan in behind us, and let's talk a little bit about this ATV over here.
What Ryan is on is a Kawasaki 650 Brute Force Independent. The independent part means the suspension front and rear are individual upper and lower A-arms along with shock absorbers. He's right now in all-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. He's going to come around onto the grass, and he's going to mount this rock to show you the ease of bringing this ATV up onto the rock with virtually no horsepower. Now, the front wheel will touch the rock, and it's not so much the back wheel's pushing it. It's going to be the front wheel pulling it up. And you can see with just no effort whatsoever, up it goes.
Wow. And you were telling me a lot of people, they don't realize that their own ATV can do something like that.
A lot of people don't know the potential of their own ATV until they see us do this. And so a lot of times we'll park ATVs out in the front just to let people know that their potential for their ATV is
And this is one of the latest as well?
Yes, this is the second from the top, the 650 Independence. We have a 650 solid axle, and then our Brute Force 750, which is our flagship model.
Okay, so we're going to see that one. So as Ryan just drives along here, we just want to go all the way to the one that you were just mentioning a little while ago. You were also telling me that this is also really great for farmers in and around the area because...
Yeah. Kawasaki's recognized that sport utility has been a very diverse unit for them. The utilitarian part because they are still workhorses, but the sport part for hunters and fishermen, and they have enough speed to get down logging roads or whenever the speed merits it.
And tell me the latest about this one.
This is our special edition Brute Force 750. It is fuel injected, independent suspension, and this particular model is called Nocturne Blue. It's a paint that's been applied through a water process, and the wheels are polished out. And Kawasaki will practice a special edition, different finish each year. So this is this year's color.
It's just so cool.
It is. It's a pretty neat machine.
We're going to show you a lot more right here. Niagara Racecrafters in Virgil. Please stay with us. We'll be right back.
Yeah, man.
So we back to Lori's. Pick the perfect weather for riding. Especially a scooter like this one. Don't you just love it? Isn't it cute? We're going to tell you a little bit more about this. Please stay with us. We're here in Niagara Racecrafters in Virgil. We'll be right back. Boom, boom.
Because me, I watch you from my eyes. I'm in love, you see. And the way you are whining and the way you are going. They say the man, I'm going to try to rush you like me, brain and stuff.
We're going back out to Lori. Hey, Lori.
Hey, Annette. And we're going to continue right here. Virgil, Niagara Racecrafters. And how about the new look of having a little scooter instead of a car or a motorcycle? This is the hottest thing out there right now. And it's not as intimidating as you think.
No, not at all. This is the SYM product line in scooters. We decided to bring this in and marry it up with Kawasaki. There is no conflict at all, and we're really proud of this product line. What you're sitting on is the Fiddle 2. This is a 125cc engine. Has that retro old world charm look to it.
It does. It really does.
And we find a lot of gals are really interested in this machine. This is capable of going up to 90 kilometers an hour, so it'll easily do Class B roads that are 80 kilometer an hour speeds. Phenomenal gas mileage. In miles per gallon, I have to speak that way because that's the way I think. This probably gets in excess to 100 miles per gallon.
How about the next one? This one right over here, the red one.
This is the HD200. It is a 171cc liquid-cooled motor. It is also ceramic-coated, so it's got a real long life to it. This is capable of doing Class A speeds. So someone needing to go on the QEW for 20, 30 kilometers would be able to keep up on traffic and not... be run over by a transport truck.
And this one is my
favorite.
Your favorite.
Own
one, yeah.
This is the RV250. This will take two people quite nicely in highway speeds. It has great little features, fold-away mirrors to tuck it in nice and tight. The weight is over 400 pounds so that it carries itself very well at speed and under windy or buffeting conditions. And the machine is bred to go 80 to 110 kilometers an hour.
Okay, so here's my question. This does weigh a little bit more than the Ninja.
Does.
Why would someone prefer something like this versus a...
It carries itself very well at highway speeds. A little bit of weight means that it doesn't move around as easily under wind conditions or buffeting conditions with vehicles passing you.
But why go for a scooter like this and not a bike? Why do you love this baby
it's
versus
an experience.
Your bike?
I like it. It's a very simple thing. It doesn't require a whole lot of thought process. If you can ride a bicycle with hand controls and a shifting, That is more complicated than riding a scooter.
We're going to try that on the next segment. Ha-ha, guess who's going to try one? Please stay with us. We're going to scoot on over to break. We'll be right back. Hey, Laura. Hey, Leslie. Even if you're interested in the scooter, you still need your M1. But here at Niagara Racecrafters, not only do they have a whole bunch of great little scooters, hey, ciao! They also have great Vulcan Voyagers like this one, and Larry's going to tell us more about it. Please stay with us. We're going to wrap it up on this morning show. We'll be right back. Down in Niagara. And we're on top of a Vulcan Voyager. Wow, this is a really comfortable bike. Once again, Larry from Niagara Racecrafters. Tell us a little bit more about this fantastic bike. This bike means business, Larry.
This is Kawasaki's top-of-the-line machine. It's 1,700 cc's, 6-speed, belt drive system. It has ABS brakes, automatic electronic cruise on it. And one of the nice features it also has on it, because it has ABS brakes, is a system Kawasaki calls K-Act. When the rear brake is applied, it actually applies the front and the rear brake on a brake bias system, and the ABS system that's tied in with the computer will control whether there's going to be a wheel lockup or not.
Who suits this bike?
Oh, gosh.
It's what kind of lifestyle?
All walks of life. We have everything from factory workers to surgeons riding these motorcycles.
So, and this is really comfortable back here.
It is.
Like, it really is a cruiser.
You could go 1,000 kilometers on this bike in a given day, and both rider and passenger wouldn't be fatigued on this motorcycle.
Okay, so we're going to give this little bike, well, this big bike, a little bit of a ride. So we're going to put on our helmet, and we have here Jeff, who's going to be helping me out here. I want to thank your daughter for allowing me to use her helmet, by the way.
Okay, I'm sure
so
she's pleased.
Put this on. All right.
Very good.
So, and if you can put that on me right there. So, once again, we want to tell everyone we are here, Virgil, Niagara Racecrafters. So, whether you're into cruisers or you're into ninjas or ATVs or even scooters, they're all right over here. All right, I'm ready. Please stay with us. We're going to continue with some more Morning Live right after this. Woo!
There she goes.
Wow, she's holding on pretty tight.
She really is.
Just gonna can't breathe.
She stayed on so far.
That's good.
Let's hope
That's
she does.
Good.
All right.